Hi, good morning, Mr. President. Tom Kindness.
Chalmers, Wiley.
I see you together.
Yes, sir.
Morning, George.
Classic president.
So good to see you.
Love, Larry.
Good to see you.
How are you?
Your vice president.
George's chair.
Yeah, I'll sit over here and listen. Sit over there, Clarence. Come on, Tom. Chalmers, you get in here so you guys can. Get the court press.
We've had that before.
This is not the first time for the whole court. What's that? $1,000 after money green that can't do it.
Well, I've been trying to think of something that we might talk about.
Well, suggestion?
Well, listen, I know all of you have concerns of varying degrees about this whole situation. And I just feel so strongly that the issue is so clear cut that if we really cut through all the disinformation that's been thrown out by the lobbyists for the Sandinista government and look at the problem. We, for example, I talked to some of your colleagues here who said, shouldn't we just negotiate, win negotiations? We've tried 9 times, and the only one who refuses to negotiate is the Sandinista government. And we believe that it's absolutely imperative that we put the pressure on them that if anything will bring them to negotiations, this is what we want. There's no thought in our mind of putting in military forces. We wouldn't have an ally left in Latin America if we did. They've still got the memories of the big colossus of the North with the Marines and all, and we're not going to do that. But we feel that we do have literally a Cuba. We've got a totalitarian Marxist government on the mainland. They've got a bigger military force now than all their neighbors combined. We know that their neighbors want us to continue doing what we're doing and offering help. And we believe that they have a sufficient force that they can make a difference there. If we provide them the weapons to, for example, Stingers to deal with those Soviet gunships, helicopters, anti-tank weapons, we believe that they can bring that force on. The last years, other than the humanitarian aid, which was limited, we haven't been able to help them, and so they have got thousands of contras that are unable to go into combat. They haven't got anything to shoot with, and we need to provide them with that help. But there's no. Come in. Why don't you go there and there?
No, but it is an important issue, and I'm having a chance to visit with you about it. Maybe explain some of my concerns.
Well, that's what I'd like to hear, because, Nancy, we know that there is a gigantic disinformation program that has affected a great many of our people out there. It's one of the reasons why I'm going to go on the air. We know that the government, the Sandinista government, is Marxist-Leninist totally. It is totalitarian. It is anti-religion. It has persecuted the Jews and burned their synagogue and so forth. We also know that the Contras have the manpower. It is increasing. And much of their manpower, a great many of these individuals, are deserters from the Sandinista army. And they do not want to overthrow. They're not envisioning going in a bloody civil war. They have announced time after time they would lay down their arms and go back and negotiate because they were part of the anti-Somoza revolution. And the Sandinista stole the revolution after victory came and ousted them. And what they want is to go back in, force negotiations that will then lead to, takeover in the Philippines, that the people will make the decisions to what they want and how they want to run. And we think that this is what we support and believe in. And not us who, not when. So this is what we want to support and see I've had some come in here, some of your colleagues, and say, well, yes, but why shouldn't you try to negotiate first? We've tried 9 times.
I agree, and I probably comment this a little bit from a different angle than some, because I couldn't agree with you more about most of what you said, in fact, all of it.
Thank you. Yes, yes, good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Good morning, sir. We're at.
Nice to see you.
Mr. President.
Yes, nice to see you this morning.
Mr. President, how's it going? I'm on a rest. Nice to see you this morning.
Great to stay alive.
Mr. President.
Jerry Ross, sir. Here, sit over here, Jim.
I remember it very well. Some of the cavalry were up, and they had a visiting general from Washington, and I remember a young cavalryman was sent to deliver a message on horseback to the two generals who were standing there, the commander of the post, with Omaha and visiting general. And he came up wide open on his horse and hit the reins. He must have had a sore mouth horse, because the horse put on the brakes, and he somersaulted right over there. And landed standing in front of the horse, hanging onto the reins with his left hand straightened up.
Mr. President, that was the old balloon school, too, right? At that same time, it was the cavalry school.
The visiting general very slowly returned to salute. As he did so, turned to his companion there and said, "Does he always dismount like this?" Well, let's get down to serious business. I didn't know what I'm going to talk about. And that's this situation coming up with the Contras and the aid. And I just don't think that there is really any choice here. What we're faced with is so strategically important and so vital. And if you think that we don't have support down in that part of the world, when I was down in Grenada, 9 prime ministers of the 9 little island Caribbean nations on their own, I never brought up the subject. They brought it up and just pleadingly said, all 9 said, "You must continue what you're doing to help, because Nicaragua, under this government they have now, represents the greatest threat to our nations. And they're tiny little nations that would be helpless. And anything was done to them." But we believe that it is absolutely essential, if we're to get, we're not talking about a civil war that overthrows the government, we're talking about bringing the Sandinistas to the point that they will recognize that it is advantageous to them to enter into negotiations with their former revolutionary allies, because most of the Contras were in that revolution against Somoza.
Something else was going on. What is that? What is it? Come on, tell me what the joke is. Marianne, somebody? Who's
it from? Might be a card, Kathy.
This.
Let's have a picture.
Is it going to explode in my hand?
One did pop.
What is this?
What are you? I could have mentioned talking to her on the phone. What are those?
I have no idea. What is
that?
I don't see a card. Wait a minute. Oh, yes.
Yes, thank you.
Jesus.
Isn't that cute?
I don't believe this.
Hold it.
What did I do? Oh, it's for the president. Okay.
What did he do?
I love him.
Oh, jeez. Okay, for the president, it says, "Thank you for inviting me to the presentation of What Works last Tuesday."
Watch out there now.
Godwin.
Joe Gessman, bilingual teacher. How funny.
Isn't that neat?
I don't think anyone has sent him balloons here before.
Oh, God.
Wait, are you going to take them in?
Sure.
After the...
I get... Well... I don't
Who's
know.
Who's he got going in there? Anybody who would invite?
Well, we have
the
press briefing.
All right.
Here we thought it was a present for you, Kathy. We're all ready.
I thought somebody heard about Shelley's birthday or something.
Yeah, sorry. Sorry.
Greg, how are you doing?
Hi.
This is the CEO, Mr. Vice President.
Hello, Mr. Rabbit. Since I'm going to see you at lunch, I'm going to sneak out of here.
Hi, how are you? I want you to see something. I'm going to give the present.
All right.
A present. You need a laugh at this point.
Jesus, that's for sure.
They're giving these out up on the hill, and I thought you want to be the first to know, Mr. President. You may want to turn this over to Bill Casey.
Top dollar for secrets. Call Stan Andrus of KBG.
Well, you need a little laugh. Oh, you might have that.
That's wonderful. Where'd you get that, Dave?
Oh, one of my staff who's an ex-Marine, a colonel, who knows all these guys in the Pentagon somewhere. And that's actually the real number, I understand. I understand it's the consulate up in New York, right?
Thanks very much.
I know someone might need a laugh this morning.
Golly, must be terrible having your name so much like that fellow's name that's on that horrible Bill Graham.
That's right. Well, you know, Hollings has got a great line, Mr. President. Hollings says, he said, the reason I don't call it Graham Rudman Hollings is because he's got more friends than the president than we do. Well, but we, you know, I'm delighted to read all of the crying and the bleeding and whatnot because interest rates are down, mortgage rates are down, and the stock market is up, people are optimistic, and that's not due just to the bill, it's due to the president's policies. The bill gave it a push, oil prices have helped, but obviously, something's going right, and the people know.
Well, of course, you know, you can explain it all. It's all due to Haley's comment.
Oh, sure. Oh, sure. Absolutely.
Well, listen, I'm concerned about our bill right now with preventing the Sandinistas from having a continued free hand to the point that we have another base on the mainland here. And I think it's so clear-cut an issue. I realize that there's been a hell of a lot of disinformation peddled throughout the country by a very sophisticated disinformation network they have going. I didn't know how sophisticated until the other day when a gentleman in here handed me a magazine, a slick paper, big magazine, $3.75 a copy. You can send your subscription in to the Nicaraguan Information Foundation. Mm. And the lead article, outright propaganda by a noted professor at UCLA, in this, but it's a Nicaraguan.
Oh, it's incredible what they're doing. There was a demonstration in my office in Portsmouth yesterday. I was very pleased to be associated with you, Mr. President, on a placard, although I didn't like what it said. It said, Reagan and Rudman are murderers, right? And these were students from, because I have supported the President's policies, and these are students from the University of New Hampshire, and one of the statements they made in their press conference was that after all, these people had fair and free elections in 1984. So I've just done a bit of an op-ed piece. I shot it up the University of New Hampshire. You better run this.